Hi friends, welcome to ODI Tutorials. Today's session I am going to explain CDC in ODI. So how to implement CDC in ODI and what are the features you will get and what are the types of CDCs in ODI. So normal, if you are talking about this is my source system and this is my target system, and inside target I am maintaining some state, you can say. This is all the target tables, and this is my source system. So my source system is a database. So what we will do? First, we will extract data from source, and we will load into staging tables. Then we will load data from staging table to within the system, staging table to our target tables. So this is the way we can go for the standard process, right? But CDC, so what is implementation of CDC? So this is general extracting data from source. Whenever you are running your mappings, so it will extract and it will load the data. But how we will identify only changed data from source, right? So that is a major thing in point of data integration project. So how to identify changed data from source? So normally we will do modified date. For example, if the source system having some modified date, for example, yesterday you have loaded the data up to yesterday, and yesterday to today, what are the transactions that happened? Those data you want to extract from here to here. You will identify if they have a system modified date. So you have to do some filter. System modified date from yesterday to today, whatever transaction is happened, like inserts, updates, or deletes, whatever it is. So we'll extract that. But instead of going for that, there is another option available in ODI, that is CDC, change data capture. So it will capture the changed data from source system. There are two ways. One is a simple and another is a consistent. Okay, this entire process we are calling in ODI journalization. That is journalization. Simple and consistent. Simple means if you are going for individual tables, and the consistent means if you have a primary key and a foreign key, that is master and child tables, relationship tables. Like if you have there are some data changed with the master data, if you want to extract both the child and master data, so that is consistent. So okay, that consistent data also you want to extract, that time we will go for consistent. And simple, that without relation, if you want independent tables, not dependent tables, that time we will go for simple generalization. So in this process, whatever DML operations is happening in my source system, it's a purely Oracle method. That is, some DML triggers will be created on your source table. And whenever they are doing some DML operations, that DML trigger will fire and it will insert into main key value into your J dollar table, that is in your staging table. Okay, so then you can identify all the modified data in your J dollar table, that is your temporary table, and you can join that to your main table and you can extract data. That table will contain only modified data. Okay, that table will contain only modified data. So, and here there are some restrictions. If source system is not allowing for DML triggers, so you can't use this simple CDC. Okay, and you have to go for again Golden Gate. Again, Golden Gate is again another DBA tool from Oracle. So it will extract data from archive log files. Okay, it will extract data based on archive logs. So archive logs will have all time stamp based extraction, so that system will identify Oracle Golden Gate. So if you are not going for Oracle Golden Gate, if source system is allowing to create triggers, you can go for using standard ODI CDC implementation. For this, we are using a separate knowledge model in ODI. That knowledge model is called journalization knowledge model. First, we have to import this. If you go to your knowledge models JKM, you can search here. My database is Oracle. I am going to use Oracle, again, as I told, there are two types of generalization, simple and consistent. I'm going to use now simple. Consistence, as I explained, if you have multiple tables with consistent data, that is with parent and child relationship data, parent key and primary key, that time we will go for set of tables, that is consistent. Individual tables, we will go for sample. Then I have created here. Then I've selected this JKM knowledge model. I'm importing here, and then your source table contain at least one primary key, okay? Because it will identify based on your primary key from your source table. So my source table, I don't have a primary key here. Let's okay. So after importing your JKM, you have to enable at your model level. So in if you open your source model, there is a tab called generalization, and again you will get a two options, consistent and simple. I'm going for simple. I'm selecting my knowledge model. Save this option. Whatever generalized tables you can see here, as of now we not done. So first we have to enable your JKM at your model. Then if you go to your right click on your model, there you can get option called add to CDC. First we need to add a subscriber, then add to CDC, then start journal. So before that, we'll create one primary key on this table. Attributes, creating an EMP number. Then, so there you can see here change data capture. If you are going for subscriber, first add subscriber here. And as of now, nothing is available. I'm creating a new subscriber, my EMP list. Subscriber is nothing but like one channel of data. If you are going for the same data using for multiple channels, that time you can create multiple subscribers. So those channels data will be created like sets. For example, one same data I'm using for multiple systems. So once you extracted data with one subscriber, that will be deleted. So they can't, other systems cannot be used there. So that time we can create a multiple subscribers list. Then they will be extracting data based on their subscriber. Okay, and they can be used those things. And start with the journal, add to CDC. Start journal. Select your synopsis. And so once you click on start journal on this table, now you can see there is an option here, green color, it is enabled CDC. Green color means it is enabled CDC. You can find the log here, because we have created generalization, right? So it will be created one table, that is a subscriber table. Default will be there, SNP subscribers, and it will be created one trigger on the source table. That is trigger is not exist, so it is because first time we are creating, trigger is not available. It's all the drop trigger, drop generator table. Now it is created one trigger on source table. You can see here, create table, JDAL table, it is created, and the primary key is your EMP number, then create trigger and the view, data view. So then generalization table. So all tables you can verify in your database. If you go to your, see here, views. YesDev, it has been created as YesDev. Let's verify it once again. So we have created it as YesDev. I will add YesDev schema here. My database connection details I'm giving here. I'm going to save and connecting my YesDev schema. So here I can see one J dollar EMP table. So that is generalization flag. Flag means whenever you are inserted, like it will be updated, that flag insert, update, deleted, and the generalization date when the data is modified in source table, and the primary key value from those tables. Okay. As of now, just now we created, as of now there is no updates in source table. Then subscribers, we have created two subscribers, right? Default default will be your synopsis, and I have created another one is my EMP list. Then go to views, you can find the two views. One is a data view and main EMP JVV JDLR view, and you can see another trigger database trigger. You can go to triggers. You can see here whenever it is inserting, it is updating flag as I. Whenever updating also, it will considering as I. Then deleting, it will consider as D. So why? Because insert and update default, it will update I. Because again, if you are using incremental update, there we are identifying with the target table, and if it is not available, it will insert. If it is available, we will update. Otherwise, you can change from here itself. It is optional actually. I'm editing. So it is not allowing this. I have edited and I'm going to compile this. Okay, it is compiled. I have whenever updating, I'm updating flag as U in my trigger. Okay. Now go to your table, right? J dollar table does not have any data here. Then in my EMP table, this is data. If I add any record here, okay, manager, I'm adding submit. Date, you can add this high date. Okay, and salary we can give. And the department number. See here, I'm created one record here. I'm going to commit this one. So my record has been committed. If you go to your J dollar table, now you can see one record with employee number and two records available. Why? Because you have a two subscribers, right? That's the reason you could see two records here with the two subscribers. Then if you want to see the complete data, you can go to your data view. You could see complete data with all other fields as well here. That is your name, employee name, date of birth, MGR, high date, and other information here. So this is the way a system will be extracted whenever any changes is happening from source table. Again, I am going to update one more record in my source table. For James, I'm updating salary 1950. This is update. Okay. It's committed. Now you can go to your J dollar table. You could see another record called flag with U. Then if I go to my J dollar view, I could see complete record. Okay, this is James record. Okay, this is new record. This is updated one, this is new one. Then, so this is the way we can go for creating and enabling JKM. So first we have to import JKM knowledge model, then we have to enable at our model level, that is a generalization top level. Then once you have enabled, you have to right click on your table and we have to add If you need to add subscriber, you can add it. And then first we have to add CDC, that is a change data capture. Then we have to start this start journal. Then you can go for verifying those changes in your system. Like it will be created once you click on start journal. Once you click on start journal, it will be created JDollar table and JDollar view and JDollar trigger. Whenever changes is happening in your source table, the trigger will fire and it will update into one main primary key record into your JDollar table, and the view will be joining into your both source table and JDollar table, and it will get the data. If you go to view, you can see the SQL query in your view. It is joining data from both source table and JDollar table, because JDollar table will contain some data which is only primary key record. That you can see here. So it is joining with the JDollar table and main EMP table. Okay, that is employee number. So this is the way it will extract all the data from source. So it will identify only changed data. So this is called journalization process. Once you have done this, it will be enabled on option your table, that is yellow color. You can see clock symbol, that is journalization. Then you can create your mapping. You can go for creating your mapping and enable your MPCDC. This is my source table. So your LKM, IKM will be same. Okay. Only if you click on source table, if you click on source table, there is a generalization option you can see here. Okay. So this is a subscriber. If you have a different subscriber name, you can modify and you can edit here. Only it will fetch the only that subscriber list data. Okay. So this is the way we can go for. This is the way we can go for creating generalization in ODI and fetching only modified data, that is changed data from source system. So how it will identify? It will identify based on this subscriber list. Based on this, you can edit this, and if you are going for other subscriber, you can change this. Now you can go to your physical model. Then LKM, IKM, you can choose LKM, SQL to SQL. I'm going to select the SQL to SQL. And here, if you don't want work tables, you can drop this, default will be dropped. If you need those work table, you can enable false. Same thing, we need to select IKM. I'm going to select control append. And if you are going for incremental update, again we have to the target table should have at least one key column to identify primary key value. For example, if you see here, control append is available. Not imported the incremental update knowledge model. What you have to do, you go for attributes. There you can see the employee number, right? So you should have at least key here. We not created any key in target table. That's why we can't use incremental update. Incremental update, if you want to use, at least one natural key or primary key is required. Because it will identify that record, based on that it will insert or update it. I'm disabling flow control here. So I'm not going to use data quality check. Save your interface. So here we have a constraint. As I told, if you want to use CDC, one constraint is required. That constraint have created at ODI level. The constraint have created at ODI level.
and resolve related to our properties under columns, that is our attributes. Okay. Now save this, and if you click on simulation, we run this. So simulation means it will run your only query. It will be generated query, but it won't load data. It won't any load any data to your target table. So here you can see the query has been generated here. Properties tab. Still, I'm not getting the properties tab here. So this option we have to select. If you go to your physical tab, if you select this generalized data only, it will be considered as a CDC option. As of now, we enable that. And it is not considered. Why? Because we have to enable that option. If you go to your physical, there is a, you could see our source table here, and you can see generalized data only. If you run on your simulation part, you can verify the complete filter condition. How will select data from source? So see here, it is selecting a subscriber. Earlier it is not selected. Now you can see it is selecting from view. Earlier it is selecting from your source table. Now it, instead of source table, it is going for JV view. That is, and again it is applying a filter called synopsis. So this is the way it will apply the condition. Now I'm going to run this. Session has been started. Now you can see here. Only two records. Why? Because we have, if you go to select query, you can see generalized LKM. So it is updating the consumed records first based on subscriber. Then it is selecting data from source table with a view condition, that is generalization view, because this view will contain only two records. We have created one, we have updated one. So this is the way we can extract data from source table, only change the data. So instead of selecting all data, we have selected only modified data from source using generalization process. This is the way we can implement JKM, a knowledge module in ODI 12C. First we have to import JKM, and next step we have to enable at model level, then enabling CDC at table level. So this is the way we can use. Then after that we have to enable option in your mapping, that is generalized data only, as well as your logical diagram. We have to give a filter condition, that is your subscriber. Okay, so this is the way we can add and enable generalization in your mapping. So thank you for watching my videos. So please stay tuned to get more updates and more videos from my channel.